Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Yooka-Laylee. So I just started up the game again, so like last time I actually quit. And what happened was, is as soon as I loaded up this page, you started talking to me. You're back and alive! It seems that snake chap lost his bet. Yeah, we, hold on, what bet? Oh, silly little, oh, that's great! Those grand tomes can be dangerous places, but it's good you're back. I have something important to share. What is it, man? The grand tomes like this one here can be expanded using the power of the pagies you have found. Choosing to expand will make the book worlds bigger and full of extra challenges to discover. Okay, so that's, yeah, this was one of the things they said. You can either open new worlds or expand old ones. That sounds cool. How does it work? Once you've found enough of us pages, it's up to you if you want to use them to expand a grand tome you've already opened, or search Ivory Towers for a brand new one. Yeah, there you go. That's the conundrum. Expand or explore. Yes, the choice is yours, as long as you do this in any order, so long as you've collected enough pages on your adventure. How exactly do we use our pages to explore or expand? Easy, just step on the switch in front. Okay, yes, I feel like this is pretty self-explanatory. I'll tell you how many pages are required to expand the tome. Got it, I guess we'll carry on our adventure now. Decide whether to expand or explore. That's the, you know, they're like, okay, so let's head out and jump back on. There you go. Let's go back. I'm not going to expand just yet because there are more stuff for me to actually do still. So we'll keep that in mind, however. So, God, these loading screens still terrify me. And it's only because whenever I see stuttering loading, it reminds me of games that I've had where the loading stutters and then it stops forever. Like whenever I use my Dreamcast nowadays. All right, let's go. So, one thing people pointed out last time, I never actually did the, broke all the things on the thing up there where they said to break them. The dude who was like, hey, help me with this, and I never actually did, so let's go do that. I also need to go run through the entire racetrack, to make sure that I get all the stuff on there. And I think, how many quills do I have? I have 19. So yeah, actually, let's go do that first, because then we can go find Trouser after and get our final power-up for this world. So for now, let's just continue with this track and make sure we get everything here. I wonder if the butterflies are still here, or if they're going to be locked away. So I think to get that one ghost rider, who, oh, that little xylophone means we're running out of power. Get that one ghost rider, I think we might need like some type of sonar power, the one that turns invisible. Because as far as I'm aware, there's no real way, like I shouldn't think of this in the style of Banjo-Kazooie, where on the first time going through you can get everything in a world, because that might not necessarily be true for this. You know, in Banjo-Tooie, that wasn't the case, where you couldn't get everything on the first try. Let's get that. Oh, no. Well, is there anything down here, though? That's a question I should look into answering. Well, we got that. There we go. Yeah, let's go down here. How do we dive again? It's this button. Hello. I don't know if I can... Nope, he's blowing me. Okay, sounds good. Let's head up. Yeah, I can't deal with this right here. Okay, it's X. Weird controls for swimming. You have a swim up button and a swim down button. I'm not sure about that. What's in this cave here? This is a super conspicuous cave. I bet you hitting that switch down there opens it. Okay. So there's some quills up there. So let's go up there. It's like, the quills I almost want to leave some, because it sort of shows areas where I've never been, right? So, might be a good idea. Hello. Oh, it's you. You're cute in a kind of cute way. The beard kind of ruins it. Oh goodness, hello, I wasn't expecting visitors. You must have been the cruddy duo Capital B is making all that fuss about. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Puzz. Oh, that's a bad name. Ivory Tower's top scientist. Well, I used to be before that dastardly Dr. Quack stole all my research. Ah, we got rival scientists. Oh, so it's literally meant to be like Humba Wumba and Mumbo Jumbo. Yooka, what's with her arms? Wait, why? Because she's four? Is that okay? Hi, Dr. Puzz. I'm Yooka, and this is Laylee. Looks like you're experiencing some tentacle or technical difficulties. Oh-ho. Oh, no, everything's okay. Better than okay, even. I've just been tweaking my favorite invention, which has the magnificent power to transform. So, yeah, this is the Mumbo. Only a damaged prototype was left behind after the horrible business with Dr. Quack, but now it's transforming as normal. Well, other than one small incident. I have an inkling. Oh, Nintendo joke. What that might have been. If you find any of the world's molecule. Oh, molecule. That's like the molecule symbol on the loading screen that I was wondering about. I can power up the DN Ray. Good name. And help you on your adventure. Apparently that fish that's in her bowl with her is actually a character from Banjo-Kazooie. Like, whenever there's a fish bowl, that exact fish is in that in a rare game. It's like that's one of those obscure things. Okay, Doc, we'll see what we can do. I better not end up with barnacles, Yooka. Oh, comedy. I mean, I enjoy this writing and, you know, of the era when this was an N64 game. It was great. And I feel like a lot of people are looking at this game with modern standards in mind. And I don't think that's what you should be doing. Because, like, it's not meant to be a modern game. It's sort of like if you went into Shovel Knight expecting it to be this fully 3D huge world of a game. And it's like, well, no. They said that this is what it was going to be. So it's like, why not just accept what it is. I don't know, man. I don't know. I mean, and I guess the thing is, I am enjoying this, but it's not earth-shattering. Like, I'm not playing this and being like, oh my god, this is the most earth, the most, okay, time limit. It's like this super amazing thing, I can't believe, okay, well, nope, we screwed that up. It's like, I can't believe that this game came out, well, I mean, I can't, as in, like, it's really cool that it came out. But what I'm trying to say is, like, this isn't like me playing Persona 5. It's not like that, you know? Like, it's a different type of game. It's super solid, and I love it. But, well, as of now, we'll see. Apparently, there's a thing later that gets a little testy. But, we'll check that out when we get there. But, oh man, this is tough. Okay, one sec. Oh, good. No, that's fine. Okay. Time trial it is. Let's try this again. But, like, I don't know. I'm of the mind that not every game needs to be a mind-blowing style of, you know, earth-shattering game development. And I feel like the problem is a lot of people just expected that to be what this is. I don't know why. Okay. Oh, we came so close. Okay. That is a little janky. But then again, that's not any more janky than some of the stuff they had you do in Banjo-Kazooie. I feel like a lot of people's memories, though, of those games are a little twisted in what they ended up having you do, you know? I mean, I love those games, but some of the challenges they make you do are nuts. Okay, so we go up here. We go here, we jump. There we go. Nice, got it. Page you get, we got 3. Looks like you found enough pages to... Oh, nice, we can expand the world. Very good. So we'll go check that out. We also now have enough to go over here. Okay. So I'm thinking I want to get... Oh, hello. I want to get that... the double jump if possible. Oh, we could probably do this now. I wonder if we can, like... Okay, so we need to hit the Two-Face... We need to hit the Nintendo Switch logo. Which is, like, up here. Then we need to hit the Elephant Face Man, who is right here. Then we need to hit the Thumbs Up, which is right here. Then we need to hit the Croissant. No, it's that. And then we need to hit the Swirly Hair Man. Where's the Swirly Hair Man? Right here. Got it. I said it's a croissant, but it's clearly a hamburger. I apologize. So, let's grab that pagie. That one was easy now that we had the power. So, we're making progress. Heck yeah. Looks like you just unlocked a tonic. Oh, nice. Come find... Nice. Let's get you. So, the play tonics actually let you change how the game works. And apparently, someone said there's one that absolutely breaks all platforming of this game. And when I heard that, I'm like, well, give that to me. Like, I will take that. So let's see. What's up, ma'am? You're still creepy looking. Hey, kids. What can I get ya? One, please. One tonic? You gotta present your company-approved ID card first, kid. Ivory Tower's employees only. Oh, I see. Ah, yes, about that. My bat friend here ate mine. Tell you what. I'll let you off just this once. We're all friendly colleagues, after all. Yes. Friendly colleagues. The name's Vendi. Okay, that's a good name. That's a good name. I assume you're familiar with my game-modifying tonics. Remember, each tonic you equip makes a big change to the rules of work. You need to complete a challenge to unlock each one, and no messing around. Only one tonic... Okay, so you can only equip one at a time. Got it. So let's see here. Gain 1 plus butterfly slot. Stun 30 enemies to unlock it, so you get super slam. Beat Rextro's thing. Collect 300 quills. Have 2 or more health extenders. Defeat 10 inept enemies. 64 bic. This one's going to be DLC. Pants. Collect every page in the game. Athlete. You're going to have to figure out how to unlock this one yourself. Finish Yooka-Laylee's story. Collect 15 ghost riders. Defeat 10 underwater enemies. Oh, fall perth. That'll be nice. Bruiser. Baller. Okay. Sounds good. Let's go. Wellard. We get one more butterfly slot. Perfect. Well, that's nice. That's a good thing to have. Bottoms up. Cute. Yeah, the 64-bit one is going to be free DLC for everyone who went and backed this game. Yes, we'll get all of yours now. And it's probably going to unlock some kind of a mini game of some sort, I'm guessing. He looks like a mini game wearing hat chap. I screwed those words up. Capital work. Come inside and we'll arrange a sporting contest for a real prize. What ho? There you go. Alrighty. So, we'll also... Okay, I just saw a... Right here. So, some more quills up here. I definitely want to... I wonder if the, like, the 100 count... is like, so we've okay, so we're missing just 4 from this world now. That's actually crazy. We almost got all the quills. So I was gonna say, I wonder if it takes into equation the ones that you've like from the expanded world, but I'm guessing not. Okay, so let's go and talk to you to get our next power. Yes, let's see here. So we get this, oh, the sonar shot, that's what we want, yeah, so that is exactly what we want to get that one Ghost Rider also. Yes, that is what we want. We're ready to learn, Trouser. Smashing! This next move I use to defeat the World 3 boss, a tricky encounter, that one.
Yeah, right, you can't even dress yourself properly.
To use sonar shot, simply use triangle to have your purple pal fire devastating blasts of sonar energy.
Sounds cool. Anything else, Worm Boy?
You can fire at enemies, stun them, or activate sonar... Okay, so that's the invisible items. But watch out, chaps. Every shot drains your power bar. Got it. Now will you be needing my 18-month insurance plan? You never know. You might have forgotten this move by next week. Alright, we're alright, thanks. Sounds good. So we got all of his things here. Yep. Okay, so... let's sonar shot this dude. Which makes these visible. Now, is this temporary or permanent? Okay, the camera is fixed right now. Interesting. Okay, so... well, there's 2 there. Is that the last 2? Okay, let's see here. Oh, and what's that over there? Well, we'll have to go check. Okay. Oh, there's 3. Yeah, that's the molecule. I think this is our... yeah, because that'll be our last quill there. Nice! And do we get a pagie for getting the last quill? Oh no. Ow. That hurt a bit. That hurt a lot. Well, let's try that again. Wonder if there's any butterflies nearby. Actually, I think this should be good for now. Okay, so this does seem to be a permanent thing. Okay. I think I just timed that wrong. So, oh, there's one. Give me that. That reminds me a bit of Spyro, which is a game I actually played a little bit of. I wonder if I can... How many shots do I get with this? It seems to be... unlimited, at least for a bit. Interesting, okay. I'll need to pay attention to that. I do like how the color changes for that, though. It does look good. Okay, so yeah, these just need to be kind of synced up a bit, and we're good. So is there just no timer? So, was that it? Yeah, 100 of 100. Okay, so I guess we just don't have the a reward for that. Which is, oh, whoa, there's more up there, though. Hello, it's me, Molecule. Take me to Dr. Puzz for a cool surprise. Gotcha, fam. Is it gonna be a bee? I feel like it's gonna be a bee. Wow, there's a lot over there that we just can't get to. Yeah, considering it says, wait, is it 100? Oh, no, it's 100 of 1,010. Okay. Huh. Oh, that's totals. Oh, wait. Hybrid Towers, we're missing one there. Okay, no, there's 200 here. Okay, that's... I was looking at the wrong everything. Got it. Sounds good. So we need to get the coin still, the butterfly extender, and there's 25 pages here. Wow, okay, so yeah, obviously, as you continue on, these are gonna... That has the totals for kind of everything. Nice. Cancelled. Great tech. Okay, so, well, let's go, we haven't gone in here yet. Let's go in here now. I was like, yeah, we got 100, but obviously 100 isn't the big deal in this one. Duke's Temple. Oh, I know what this is gonna be. This is gonna be terrible. I'm excited. Good day, strapping adventurer. Adventurer, splendid day for a hunt, whatnot. Whoa, aren't you supposed to talk simple, run straight at us? Like those Neanderthals in Hyvory Towers? Absolutely not. I'll have you know that I'm the most aristocratic character in the game. Not likely. There's a guy with a huge ice palace in the next... Wow, he must be loaded. Thanks for clearing the windows up top, whatnot. Whatever, we've done the dirty work. Now hand over the pagie. What? Give you my posh paper, leaving me with just the local fauna? Should nature call? Not likely. He's using it for toilet paper. Although, I do like a sporting contest. I propose you take on my target challenge. I'll provide the targets you based on my Neanderthal brethren. You shoot the blazes out of all of them, and I'll surrender my pagie, what? What do you say? Fancy a shot at my target range, chaps? Yeah, man, let's do this. Let's give this a shot. It sounds fun. Let's shoot. Jolly good. Stand on the spare target I laid down, and don't forget your ammo. Down the common beasts, and I'll award the pagie. All right. Well. Oh, it's gonna suck. Is there a first-person view? There is. Good. Okay. Oh, this is gonna be the worst. This is gonna suck. Okay. Stop. Out of this view. Out of this view. Oh, man. Oh, jeez. Okay. Stop. Top shooting for a couple of run-of-the-mill peasants. Feel like I prepared you to take on the rest of the corporate minions in the game. Oh, that's it? Oh, we're good? Okay. Okay. That felt like it needed an N64 controller. I didn't feel safe using this controller. Surprisingly, by the end of Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, I feel like I've mastered the N64 controller. And whenever people say that they hate that controller, I tell them that they're wrong. And it's now to a point where, now in my character art, which I got done by Mika Frar, who is, I think it's Mika Frar is how you pronounce it, who actually does the JonTron art, that's the only time I will mention his name in this entire playthrough. I have him hold the N64 controller because I love the N64 controller. So, the last one is going to be... This is kind of a cool idea. I mean, they're not temporary platforms, so as of right now, they're not something I worry about too much. But, hey man, give me this. Cool. We are getting... Yeah, so you definitely get pagies a lot faster than you get jiggies. I mean, there are double, so it would make sense. But it's still a little surprising, you know? So let's go get our transform... Well, actually, I think we're going to expand the world first, and then we'll get the transformation. Because I feel like that just makes sense, you know? Well, okay, let's... There we go. So let's see here. Okay, so just stuns them temporarily. That's pretty good. Hello. Yeah, there's definitely more than 100. I was so excited to get the 100, and lo and behold. Wow, we haven't even looked here yet. Nope. Just kidding, we're not gonna come here just yet. Gosh! I seem to have gotten myself into a pot of bother.
Oi! No need for name calling!
Oh, hilarious. Do we have to burn him with fire powers? Oh, wow, we just have the ability to just fire breath everything. That's actually really surprising. I thought they'd be little fireballs, not flamethrower breath. Alright. Sounds good. Yeah, so it is just super temporary. So do we have to heat this up? No? What's up, my man? Oh, she! She's looking a bit malnourished. I didn't tell that was a girl. Cripes! Thank goodness you're here. I've been kidnapped by these things, and they're gonna cook me.
If they're hungry, they'll need a character a bit more fleshed out than you, love.
Oh, funny. Gosh, it seems you just can't be a world-class explorer these days without being cooked and eaten. Help me escape and I'll reward you with a pagie. But be quick, my captors will be back any minute with their condiments. Yeah, sounds good. We'll give this a shot. Don't worry, miss. We'll get you out of there.
Oh, step away from the pot, strange dinosaur. We are not a dinosaur.
He better be holding ketchup. Aw. Darn it. Alright, we're gonna grab this. Then we can just do this. Nice! Alright, let's go. Skeleton soup, add much body. Hilarious. Yeah, that actually works really well. Ow. I hope these dudes just, like, run at me and not them. Oh, that's it? Looks like dinner's cancelled. Oh, quirky, funny, hilarious comedy. Okay, now just give me my thing, though. Give me my thing. What's up? Oh, thank you, Cat and Lizard. You have my eternal gratitude. Those brutes took a real beating, but I have a feeling they'll be back. Can you feel it in your bones? Okay, that's pretty good. Yeah, give me the pagie. Pages and cagies, who'll set them free? It's Yooka and Laylee. Okay, so this is obviously where the world will be expanded upon. I kind of like that, how you can just sort of see... Oh, hello. Get back here. Oh, no. Oh, jeez, I made a grand mistake. I can save this. Oh my god, I can't believe that. You suck. Get back here. Yeah, we did it. We gotcha. I definitely need to find that other one, though. I almost wonder if I should just focus on this now before I... Well, I'll save my transformation for later, for sure. But I want to find that other ghost dude, at least. Because then I'll remember that I got the sonar, and I'll be able to find him. Where was he? He was like in a little crevasse. Gotta find the crevasse. Man, back in the day, I used to watch a show called The Weekenders. It was on our Disney Channel. Now we have Disney Channel, but back then it was called, it still is, but Family Channel, right? And it was a Disney show, but they had a whole episode about this place called the crevasse. And it was about this, the main guy, Tony, he's like, guys, we gotta go to the crevasse, and it's the coolest place ever. And then the crevasse became like a street, just like a normal, everyday, you know, like highway. But the crevasse was no more, but he agreed that, like, he was like, no, these guys need to know about the crevasse. And now I can't say crevasse without thinking of that, you know, so. Is there anything up here? No, that might be a path for later. I do like these worlds, though. Like, I mean, as of now, like, I really do like how this world is kind of set up. It's set up in a way where I'm enjoying exploring it and just seeing what is around and, I don't know. I definitely feel like there's a lot of people who are looking at this game through an incorrect lens. And it's interesting, because I even had people commenting on this saying, like, I've heard people say this game is terrible, and I'm like, what? No, and there, oh, Rextro's over there. And there are people who have said that this is a mighty number 9 level of wrong. And I'm like, oh my god, you are a mighty number 9 level of wrong, at least in what you're saying right now, because, like, that's not correct, what you're saying, you know? Man, there's still so much to explore. It's so densely packed. It's interesting, because I feel like there's people saying that it feels too barren. I feel like this is too densely packed. I don't know what they're talking about, man. Oh, listen to that. Listen to that retro beepiness. I love it. I love his Rextro's design. He looks so good. Oh, man. Okay, well, we'll deal with him after. I want to find the Ghost Rider still. Unless I get one of them for beating his game, which might happen. I wonder if the world adds, like, shortcuts when you expand it. Like, for instance, you know, like the bridge there. That'll just make my life easier to get here. I don't know. That'd be interesting to see what happens. Gotta look for any of those other secrets around here, though. Because, you know, you do this racetrack, and you're like, you run through it so fast, you don't even know what's around you. Okay. Well, I think we're about good. We're at about a half hour mark. So, guys, next time we'll go expand the world, maybe. We'll explore a bit more. There's still a lot to do here. I'm really enjoying this. I don't know. Maybe I'm just the right audience who played the other two games, and I'm getting into it, but we'll see you next time for some more Yooka-Laylee. Ciao.